You know, the old days where the U.S. Marshal would show up like in the movies, what's that guy's name? I remember his name in the movie, Bobby Sam Jones. Gerard. Bobby Lee Jones.
Isn't that Bobby Lee Jones?
Isn't that Bobby?
Tommy Lee Jones.
Tommy was my TV guy. Pretty something was off.
You know the days where Tommy Lee would show up and say, okay, I'm in charge, everybody get out of here, you yo-yos. And boot everybody off, or the sheriff would show up and boot off the local police force. We can't do that. You know, the terrorists...
What's that? Oh, why not?
The terrorists in 911 ran through the jurisdictional gaps. If you're studying and reading about 911, you'll learn that we had the evidence. It was just in different places. And they weren't communicating. Because they had this pride in their agency and this jurisdictional boundary. We can't do that anymore. So we have to break that down. Now, we had the S.A.U.S.A.s, Special Assistant United States Attorneys, who are my assistant attorneys general. That's what I did as AG. And it made a difference in all kinds of investigations. I remember when we got evidence of crystal meth coming into Manhattan, Kansas. And you see, while I was AG, because of a lot of good people, meth labs went down 70% in Kansas. So we were able to refocus our efforts at the organized criminal element of drugs, the gangs, that were bringing crystal meth that was cooked in the super labs into Kansas. And we were getting evidence of this. And you could tell it was cooked in a super lab because of its purity. And methamphetamine, folks, is not an experimental drug. It is a destroyer. 95% addictive on the first hit, it destroys them. And so we executed a raid in Manhattan, Kansas, and we did 20 search warrants, and we picked up meth at every place. And then I decided to take the case fed. And I'll tell you why. Because Kathy, and I'm sorry to use you, you're not on film, so your neighbors won't know about this, but use you as an example. Say I picked up Kathy, who had meth on her, and I was taking this state. I'd come up to you and I said, Kathy, you know, it's a crime for you to have meth, but what I'm really interested in is who's having you sell. Who are the big fish here? Who are the people that are profiteering on others' misery? And Kathy, if you don't tell me who's giving it to you, you're going to get probation. And I'll tell you what. Let me tell you something else, Kathy. If you're on probation and I catch you using meth, you're going to get probation. And then if you really make me mad and do it again, it's probation for you. That's exactly what they did. But take it fed, got a federal grand jury, and I said, Kathy, I'll tell you what, you're facing 5 to 30 years in federal prison, depending on what you tell me right now. Yes, you're going to be. Bam, she ran you out, buddy. These guys, they sing better than a church choir. And we took it up the food chain. And we busted dealers in Colorado. And we broke down the Corpus Christi mob out of Texas. It was a gang that had formed in the mid-90s. They had super meth labs in Mexico and in California. And we shut them down because we were willing to look past these jurisdictional fights and say, when we're trying to keep Kansas safe, we're going to put all the tools on the table and decide what is best. And that's what we did. And that's the change that I brought here. They didn't used to do that here. I now have Special Assistant United States Attorneys in the DA's office, the first ever. And we are able to take our cases to federal court if there's a more severe penalty. Now, we passed Jessica's law, so the feds come to us a lot on these child crimes. Sometimes I go to them. It depends what the allegation is. But a lot of times they come to us. But I'll tell you where it makes the biggest difference is financial crimes. Any of you work in a small business or operate a small business? Ben Paul?
Yeah.
What would happen if somebody took you for 80 grand? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you hate to think about it. I mean, that's a blow. That puts people in bankruptcy. That kills the business. That takes away college for a child. What is their penalty in Kansas if they took you for 80 grand? Probation. But you know, most of these crooks now use some kind of internet communication or telephone communication, or use a banking system that's federal, and so we have a federal nexus and I can charge them with a federal crime. But the problem is the feds are too overwhelmed. They won't take any case if it's less than 100 grand of loss. So what I do now is I go to the feds and say, I know you don't have an attorney to prosecute this case, but I'll put Brad Burke in federal court. Eric, he's an assistant U.S. attorney now. And he goes, great. And we take those guys, and we take them fed, and we put them in prison. And you know what else happens now that I do that? The defense attorneys hate it. Because if I got some guy dinging people for 60 grand and bouncing across the state line, all I have to do is say, you know, I'm thinking about taking this fed. Oh, Phil, let's talk about this now. We'll do restitution. We'll do some time in the state pen, but we don't want a federal prison rap on this guy. We're able to move it a lot better for your safety.